Welcome to TradersArmy.com, defending your right to build wealth and preserve capital for generations to come.
Good morning, everybody. Welcome to the Wednesday morning edition of the Daily Market Commentary. I am your host, Chuck Fulkerson. Hope everybody had a great trading day yesterday, although there wasn't a whole lot to talk about. Let's go ahead and dive right into what's happening so far today. So the S&P is down about 2 points this morning, as really we've gotten a whole lot of nothing. I don't have a whole lot to add today, more than what we talked about yesterday. But yesterday we talked a little bit about the slowing of momentum, and we can certainly see that slowing of momentum in action yesterday. We were looking at two potential longs. Those areas still remain in play heading forward, but as it stands right now, not a whole lot of movement has really occurred. We've come off of our high from yesterday afternoon that we kind of rallied up through, but not a whole lot going on. Now, yesterday in the Nasdaq, we did have a breakdown in play, but for those of you that are subscribers of Traders Army in our trade feed update, because we always put our trade feed update, we had talked about the fact that since this breakout occurred on Globex lows, we were moving that stop to break even right away. And thank goodness that we did, because we immediately popped right up after the video yesterday. So no harm, no foul, if you will. But really, it's really done a whole lot of nothing ever since then. Now, we are, once again, still, that level could still be viable. That line could be viable again, as we are now just basing in front of it. But for the now, I'm gonna remove it and just kind of sit on my hands a little bit. Now all these upper wicks that we've had over these last few hours, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hours in a row now on these 60-minute charts of these upper wicks, tells me, okay, maybe we do have a little bit of weakness that's brewing. On a 15-minute chart, well, there's really not a whole lot of great levels to look at, even on a 15-minute chart, but we are indeed starting to come down from that region. And what I would say is there's no reason to force a trade, and so what I'm going to do is hold off on really doing too much of anything in this market condition, as we are just giving it a fair amount of chop. Crude oil, we have a breakout to the upside kind of in play here, just above this blue line. So we popped just briefly above it last night, but didn't get any follow through on it. And really, it's been just kind of still sideways price action. Although if you did get long on the pop out, there's no reason to get out quite yet, as we are still overall bullish in crude oil because it's not coming below our prior pivot. And then gold we did get was really our biggest mover yesterday as we continued our strong price action in gold. That's really what we've seen, is our strongest price action has been in the gold markets over the last early part of this week. It's been a very strong price action, and so now we've put in a new area where we might want to add to our level right in through here. This 1331 half by 1337. There are, we continue to just march higher and cruise higher. But as we see gold kind of marching and cruising higher, interestingly enough, I'm going to throw, and I don't look at the VIX all that often. We're also seeing a VIX that's continuing to come down. Now, I would have anticipated yesterday if we had seen the market was basically flat, gold was rallying, you'd have a lot more to worry about if you saw VIX start to spike, right? Start to rally. But we're not seeing that in this instance. We're not seeing a rallying of the VIX. We're seeing the VIX actually continue to come down. Now, we don't really, I don't talk too much about the VIX, but the VIX is essentially our fear gauge, right? Think of it as a fear gauge in the markets. When people are most concerned is when the VIX will tend to spike. And what I look for, and really what happened at the end of January of last year, was when we started to see the markets setting in new highs, but the VIX continuing to rise. combined with gold rising. And that's what we have right now, but we don't have the VIX rising. So just kind of something to keep in mind. Although we see market weakness overall, we don't see that follow through coming in its corresponding markets. All right, bonds, currencies, all that fun stuff. So in our currency markets and our bond markets, we're still between our major levels. So basically, those of you that watched yesterday's video, those are all still viable levels. We still had a reversal point down in here, and our next area of really any substance is this in the bonds is up above us. So we are rallying in the bonds at this moment. Not a whole lot I want to add. No super quality levels in here, and I don't necessarily need to force it. In the Aussie, a level I had looked at yesterday, I was working, doing a one-on-one with one of our site members, and we were talking about this level down here for a potential opportunity on the 1 hour chart. Actually, that's a 15-minute level. So we had first looked at this area here in the 1 hour, I didn't love this 1 hour level because when I saw this level here, we were looking at it right about this area, and it didn't give me enough quality reward to risk to make it worthwhile. Now it's giving me even less reward to risk, and so I've got to go a bit lower to find something that might be worth using. And so I go down to the 15-minute chart, and on the 15-minute chart, there's this little level right in here. So I'm going to make that purple to accommodate for the 15-minuteness of the level. And so that would be our area to look for. In the euro, level is still up above us in this region here, kind of chopping along sideways in front of it. So just be aware of that. I jokingly sometimes call this the Batman trade, where you have these two wicks up here. So, you know, there is the potential of a breakdown below this demand. We've hit it once. We've traded into it a second time. There is a potential for a breakdown below that area, so just keep that area in mind. It's no longer going to be an area I'd look at for a long, but there is a potential for a breakdown if we get below here. Canadian, this was frustrating. We based before the level, we got a little bit of a breakdown, and then boom, it just popped right back up through it. So unfortunately, this one did not work out in our favor, as we got the breakdown and then just the follow through just wasn't there. And I spoke about this yesterday on how if you wanted to give it a flyer, it did set up. But in this one, there was nothing, there was no follow through in it. And follow through is important, right? We got to look at the follow through on a level. Think about follow through on a level like that of a golf swing, right? If you've got a short follow through, then what does it do to your probability of success, right? What does it do to my probability of success? Let me give you an example. So Japanese yen, another one that we had a breakdown in yesterday, that on our private trade feed, we had talked about, move that stop to break even. And for me, it was because of the follow through. And what I mean by that is we had basically, we broke down, we chopped sideways for a couple of candles, then we got a gift of one more candle, and then it continued to chop sideways. So basically, I wasn't getting the follow through that told me, okay, this is a great setup. So we moved our stop down to break even pretty early in the trade. And then it popped back up. Now, I think that it's still overall going to continue to go down, which is sometimes the most frustrating thing, because then it popped right back up to the origin of the move, which caused the breakdown, and we've sold off from that point. I think that there's still probabilities that it'll continue to fall, and if you wanted to trade this on a candle-to-candle style, then there would be nothing wrong with doing that at this point from here. So look for that follow through more often than not. Inside of the Great British Pound, the level we looked at yesterday was the breakdown below here, with this area up here as a potential reversal. Now we've come into this level up here. Depending on how tight you set your stop, we've gotten, you know, very little movement out of it from that point. You may or may not still be in that position. If you are, I think that it's fairly weak. at this point, although I do anticipate the retracement of this big speed candle. So I think that you still could get another continuation of the leg down. So not a whole lot to do with this at this, you know, exact moment in time. I'm not adding a bunch of levels. Today could be one of those days where we see a lot of these levels get cleared out. You know, through either a pullback. You notice that on our ES level, both of the levels that are closest to us are 15-minute reversals, and then it's a breakdown, right? So that tells me that these are not super strong levels, and our momentum is weaker. So we may see price start to come down throughout the day. Keep an eye on the trade feed as far as we may wind up entering in some of those short positions, as price falls, if indeed that it does. I don't want to short though until the market gives me something definitive that tells me that I should be doing it. And right now it's just not doing that. So discretion is the better part of valor, as I like to say. But I hope you guys all have an absolutely amazing day. If you want to learn more, go to tradersarmy.com, promo code TRADEUP, and get 60% off your first month. So, all right, everybody, have a great day. See ya.